You may have heard that to get over an addiction, one just needs to be strong enough to resist temptation. But you may be wondering, is willpower enough to prevent someone from relapsing? Willpower is otherwise known as self-control, and there is a common misperception that people with addictions simply need to exert enough control over their impulses to prevent themselves from relapsing. This video will explore what addiction really is, how it works, and will explain the various treatment options that are available to help with addiction. Throughout this video, we will be dismantling the myth of willpower and addiction by explaining why willpower is not enough. First, we'll start off with a few definitions to help you understand some of the terminology around the topic of addiction. Drug abuse is any time drugs are used outside of the supervision of medical professionals, whereas addiction is compulsive drug abuse despite the significant negative consequences that arise from this behavior. It is important to understand that addiction is a chronic medical illness that is characterized by a compulsive need to seek the drug, a loss of control in limiting intake, and a negative emotional state when access to the drug is prevented. This means that addiction does not just go away when the symptoms are resolved. It can return at any time, and it can even be worse than it was before. Chronic drug use leads to some of the characteristic symptoms of addiction. Drugs begin to have less of an effect after they are consumed multiple times, and this is known as tolerance. Dependence occurs when the function of cells and systems that are normally used changes to compensate for the presence of the drug. Lastly, withdrawal includes the negative physical and emotional symptoms that are experienced when a drug that someone is dependent on is no longer taken. These symptoms can include nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, anxiety, and insomnia. Now that you understand some of the basics of addiction, how does it affect the brain? The exact ways that chronic drug use affects the brain depends on the type of drug that is being used, but all drugs of abuse change the function of the reward circuit within the brain. This system is normally activated by the release of dopamine in response to a reward or a pleasurable experience. This release of dopamine, which is pictured on the left, is what causes people to continue to seek out pleasurable experiences. Drugs of abuse take advantage of this system by always causing the release of dopamine in this circuit, even if the experience of taking the drug is no longer pleasurable. As drug use increases, so does the presence of dopamine, and so the brain makes modifications to become better adapted to an environment that has elevated dopamine levels. These modifications include changes in the way one's DNA is expressed, which influences the functioning of their brain and changes their behavior. These changes in DNA expression that occur after the frequent use of drugs of abuse eventually lead to addiction. These changes are what makes someone dependent on their drug of choice, and so their continued use of the drug becomes a need rather than a choice. Addiction has been shown to involve the same processes as learning does, and this is important in understanding why willpower is not enough to prevent relapses. When someone takes a drug, anything that is in their environment is associated with the pleasurable experience of taking that drug. This means that the room, the time of day, their clothing, and even the people they are with are tied to the act of drug consumption. In other words, the brain has learned that these situations are linked to the pleasurable release of dopamine from taking drugs, and therefore makes the person seek out drugs to recreate this experience. This becomes an automatic process within the circuitry of the brain with chronic drug use, which triggers behaviors that the individual has no control over. Simply having the willpower to resist a pre-programmed temptation is not sufficient because we cannot control something that occurs outside of our consciousness. Other factors that can contribute to relapse include depressive symptoms, stress, lack of social support, peer influence, family environment, and genetics. If we cannot rely on people having the willpower to resist temptation, how can we treat addiction? The first step in addiction management is treating the withdrawal symptoms. These symptoms are a major part of the reason why people continue to use drugs, and they often require 24-hour medical assistance to be manageable. Providing better resources for people who want to stop their drug use is essential because people with addictions require the help of others, not just their inner strength, to overcome this difficult stage in disease management. After someone has completed the withdrawal process, they typically attend a rehabilitation program that isolates them from any possible triggers and provides them with cognitive and behavioral therapies. Support groups like Alcoholics Anonymous and Narcotics Anonymous are also beneficial because they provide people with a social support system that is critical in preventing relapse. Another method is to completely remove the individual from any triggers that may induce relapse. This could include moving to a new home, neighborhood, or city, ceasing any interaction with the people they took drugs with, and finding a new job. Medication-assisted therapies are another option to manage addiction, but they do simply trade one dependency for another. For example, drugs such as dolefine, methadone, and suboxone are used for opiate replacement therapy. One of these medications will be medically provided to individuals with opioid addictions to help prevent symptoms of withdrawal. However, these drugs do not get the individual high, and they do not provide the euphoric effect associated with drugs of abuse. Even with all of these prevention measures, individuals are likely to relapse at least twice before successfully managing their addiction. Lastly, we want to disclaim that if you or anyone you know is suffering from addiction, know that you are supported and your help is important. Individuals can find support in Canada from the Center for Addiction and Mental Health, Canadian Addiction Treatment Centers, or Kids Help Phone. Individuals can also access help across the world from Smart Recovery, Alcoholics or Narcotics Anonymous, and Global Addiction Recovery Services. Now let's test your knowledge about what we have learned today. Which factor can lead to drug addiction and relapse? Peer influence, wearing a certain outfit, walking in a familiar neighborhood, or all of the above? What form of addiction treatment provides social support? Withdrawal management, Alcoholics or Narcotics Anonymous, medication-assisted therapies, or cognitive and behavioral therapies? What does opiate replacement therapy not provide? A reduction in cravings, a reduction in withdrawal effects, euphoric effects, or prevent the symptoms of withdrawal? Thank you for watching today, and we hope you can better understand how addiction works and why self-control is not enough to prevent relapse.